All right, what's up, guys and girls? Quick video. This is for those who wants to have MIDI inputs in their sounds, like this, whatever this thing's called, in Native Instrument Contact. I got a comment from Carl Hands about the MIDI channel, so here's a quick video on that. Hopefully, I could beat my grandma to, well, not beat my grandma, but hopefully, I could do this in peace. My grandma's here. She might bother me. Okay, so first thing, once you load Native Instrument Contact, you would want to click on this gear icon, go to the handling tab, and make sure this is set on Omni. If it's on Assign for Free, set it to Omni, right? Then you gotta delete the plugin. Then you gotta re-upload it, or thing it, put it on. Good. Next, go to Game Audio Cart, Super Audio Cart, that's what I'm using. Cool. Now if I hit keys, let me lower it down. We got the default one. If I set this to MIDI track number 3, we don't have it. If I set it default, you hear the bass. So if I set this on 2, you hear nothing. That's pretty much because we gotta switch to a different channel now. So there's two ways of doing this. First, right click the piano roll, go here. See this button right here, or this color? It says color group slash MIDI channel number 1. Click here, go to 2. See over here it says 2. Cool. If I click here, go to 3. Cool. If I set up a new one and I set this to channel 7, or yeah, 7, go to channel 7. Yeah, buddy. So from there, you could go ahead and record. Cool. And make sure this button right here is on overdub, because if it's not and you record channel 1 or something, no, like channel 2, let's go channel 2. If I hit record, you can see it deleted crap. You don't want that. You want everything. Ugh, boy. So make sure this is on so you can record over the sound. So you can see we pretty much went over the sound. And we're good. That's the first way and pretty much the cool way to do it. The old school way, which is like FL12 and all that. If you use FL12, right click, insert, MIDI, MIDI out. And then in the contact, click this gear icon at the top, go there, go to input port, set it to something like 0 or 1. There you go. I'm putting on 1 because I like number 1. Because I'm number 1. Channel 1. You can see I have nothing set on channel 1. So let's just put this on channel 1 right there. Channel 1 in the MIDI out. Make sure this is selected green. And you're on it. If I go to channel 2, we get nothing. 3. Cool. If I go to 7, if I can reach, we got number 7. But in this case, yes, like I said, you go into the piano roll or whatever and you record your stuff. But you cannot do like what I did in the other one and go to like, hey, I want to record channel 3. Nope. It's the same signal 1. 7. Nope. Same 1. What you have to do then is just clone it. And then in this, we change the channel to whatever, 7. And then do the whole shenanigans. There it is. So hopefully this video was helpful to you guys and girls out there that have the question about the MIDI channels with Native Instrument Contact. Hit thumbs up if it did, and thank you for your comments and all that. If you got a question, drop it down. Maybe someone else could help you. No, I'll probably try and help y'all as well. So yeah, thank you. Peace. I'm out.